Hey, welcome to this how-to video on how to play the Kingdom Hearts series. Now, I will make this perfectly clear at the very beginning. If Twitch or YouTube tries to censor my videos, they need to keep in mind what I'm doing here does not violate Square Enix's fair use policies. So, with that in mind, let's get going.
I've been having these weird thoughts lately. Like, is any of this
Is
for
for
real
real or
or
not?
not?
Alright, sorry about that. Now, we start the tutorial. And I hope whoever's watching takes what I'm about to show and say to heart when you're playing the game for the first time. So, without further ado, let's move. Now, each item increases a particular stat, be it attack for the sword, magic for the staff, and defense or vitality for the shield. Now, which one you choose all depends on your playstyle. So, when I'm playing, I usually get this one for the first thing. Now, what you give up is crucial. Now, when I'm doing this, I get rid of magic. As useful as it is, I'd rather be attack and defense heavy. So, we get rid of the staff in my case. Now, I get my sword. Yes. Now remember, I chose right away because I was already sure. Now if you're not sure, you can take all the time you need when you're choosing. Okay? You just have to make sure when you're choosing, you choose the playstyle you want. Not what other people want. All right, so general attacks and general configuration will be explained to you throughout the game. The tutorial is pretty thorough on the basic mechanics of the game. Now, you'll see my HP and MP in the bottom right of the screen. Obviously, for all intents and purposes, once your HP hits zero, it's game over. Magic will sometimes use entire MP bars, or it all depends on the spell. Now, these are the most basic forms of enemies in this game. Shadows, they're heartless. Now, note, you'll gain experience by defeating enemies. Now, as you move forward, you'll be able to, and some enemies will drop health orbs, money orbs, magic orbs, or items. So, keeping that in mind, some enemies will only drop certain items and vice versa. Okay? Most of the gameplay throughout the entire series is usually pretty standard. Now, always remember to pick up any orbs you the enemies drop. It's very important, just in case you accidentally you take damage unintentionally. Okay, let's keep going. Now, the most notable difference between this version of Kingdom Hearts and its original is it did not have reaction commands, that the field icon that is pointing out there. So, let's check this out. Item boxes will look like that. Sometimes they'll look a little bit different. So keep in mind when you're actually in the field destroying enemies. Sometimes chests will contain valuable items, weapons, accessories, you name it. They could be found in chests or dropped from enemies. But that won't stop you from buying some of these items in stores either. That's where money comes into play. On we go. I am mostly making these how-to videos because there are some people that have a hard time with these games, and I would actually like them to actually enjoy them as much as I do. So, going through the entire, through most of the series, and as I'm playing, I'll be explaining different bosses, enemy types, and how to deal with them. So, sit back, relax, and enjoy. This is a point where you actually put your own personal touch on the story. On this question, just be yourself, or any of them, really. Choose what you want, and be confident in your decision. at that point, you could go back and change your answers to the questions if you so choose. But after this, the game starts in earnest. So sit back, enjoy, and I hope you learn something from this. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. Let's go. Now, be patient when you're in combat, okay? You'll need that patience for clear choice-making. That is a save point. It'll heal your magic and your health and allow you to save your game. So, save often if you can, because you don't want to lose progress as you're making it. When you're facing giant enemies, do not be afraid. That'll be nothing more than a hindrance. Just focus on their weak points, and you'll be fine. Sometimes enemies can get really big and intimidating, but don't let that ever get to you. This is what is known as a dark side. Whenever you level up, you'll get stat increases, which will show for your character in red at the upper left hand corner of the screen. Sometimes you'll get new abilities, sometimes your magic, strength, or defense will increase. Sometimes those upgrades will even come as a special reward from defeating certain bosses.
Kyrie.
Sorry, you lazy bum. I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream.
Or was it?
I don't know. What was that place?
So bizarre.
So bizarre.
Yeah, sure.
Say, Kyrie. What was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
You ever want to go back?
Well, I'm happy here.
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other worlds out there. I want to see them all.
So what are we waiting for?
Hey! Aren't you guys forgetting about me? So, I guess I'm the only one working on the raft. And you're just as lazy as he is.
So you notice.
So you notice. Okay, we'll finish it together. I'll race you.
Huh?
What? Are you kidding?
Ready? Go!
Technically, I should be playing Birth by Sleep for chronological purposes, but that one's a little less like the rest of the series, so I'm trying to put in set up certain guidelines to your playthrough of the games. All right, let's do this. Each item that you have to collect will be in relatively easy to get areas, so keep an eye out. The rope you'll find over in this area. And the cloth will be in here. simple. And once you get all these items, just bring them back over to Kairi so you can continue.
So, Kairi's home is out there somewhere, right?
Could be. We'll never know by staying here.
But how far could a raft take us?
Who knows? If we have to, we'll think of something else.
So, suppose you get to another world. What would you do there?
Well, I haven't really thought about it. It's just, I've always wondered why we're here, on this island. If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one? And suppose there are other worlds. Then ours is just a little piece of something much greater. So, we could have just as easily ended up somewhere else, right?
I don't know.
Exactly. That's why we need to go out there and find out. Just sitting here won't change a thing. It's the same old stuff. So let's go.
You've been thinking a lot lately, haven't you?
Thanks to you. If you hadn't come here, I probably would have never thought of any of this. Kairi, thanks.
You're welcome.
Sora! You wanted one, didn't you?
A palpa fruit.
If two people share one, their destinies become intertwined. They'll remain a part of each other's lives, no matter what. Come on, I know you want to try it.
What are you talking?
Looks like the temperature
is... It's nice to see you, what?
Hey there, Donald. Good morning.
We've got a problem, Dookie. But don't tell anyone.
Ooh. Queen Minnie?
Not even the queen.
Daisy?
No! It's top secret.
Oh, good morning, ladies.
What?
Thank you.
Alright, here we go. Let's get going. Nice cup of coffee. Now, here's another fetch quest, so just take your time and pay attention. No, not quite yet. Thank you. Alright, for now, I am going to pause the game. Because I have to go somewhere real quick.
Who's there?
I've come to see the door to this world.
Huh?
This world has been connected.
Well, what are you talking about?
Tied to the darkness. Soon to be completely eclipsed.
Well, whoever you are, stop freaking me out like this. Huh? Well, where did you come from?
You do not yet know what lies beyond the door.
So you're from another world?
There is so very much to learn. You understand so little.
Oh yeah? Well, you'll see. I'm gonna get out and learn what's out there.
A meaningless effort. One who knows nothing can understand nothing.
We'll just have to trust the king.
Gorge, I sure hope he's all right.
Behind us. Don't worry. We'll find the king and the key.
Thank you. Both of you.
Daisy, can you take care of them?
Of course. You be careful now, both of you.
Oh, and to chronicle your travels, he will accompany you.
Over here!
Cricket's the name.
Cricket's the name. Jiminy Cricket. Jiminy Cricket, at your service.
We hope for your safe return. Please, help the king.
You're coming to me, Palooza.
Gorsh, Jiminy, your world disappeared too?
It was terrible. We were scattered. And as far as I can see, I'm the only one who made it to this castle.
Oh, right. I gotcha. You mean while we're in other worlds, we can't let on where we're from, huh? We gotta protect the world border.
Order.
Right. World border. Oh, I guess we'll need new duds when we get there, huh?
And they get dropped out. Love it. All right, here's where everything gets started.
Wait. Once we set sail, it'll be great.
A storm?
Oh no! The raft!
Sora! Dinner's ready! Come on down! Sora?
All right, here we go.
What's that? Riku's boat and Kairi's.
Remember, at this point, you won't be able to affect them.
Where's Kairi? I thought she was with you.
The door is open.
What?
The door is open, Sora. Now we can go to the outside world.
What are you talking about? We We've got to find Kairi.
Kairi's coming with us. Once we step through, we might not be able to come back. We may never see our parents again. There's no turning back. But this may be our only chance. We can't let fear stop us. I'm not afraid of the darkness.
Riku.
While you're in this area, I recommend you farm as many experience points as possible before you actually get to the end of this segment. That way you can at least be at least one or two levels higher than you need to be. But once you start getting overwhelmed, I recommend that you get moving after that. So if you stay long enough to farm additional levels, I recommend you make sure every area is clear of the heartless before you get moving.
Come on!
So yeah, grinding for levels early on in the game is a good way to stay alive. And with any luck, you'll have at least 3 level up by the time you get out of here. So, at minimum, you should be at least level 5 by the time you leave here. If you do your due diligence.
Kyrie!
Sora...
Oh yeah, and I forgot to mention, there is, you have to fight this thing a second time. There. And I forgot to make this statement earlier. Spoilers are in effect. So, just, you've been warned.
Oh, look! A star's going out!
Come on, let's hurry!
And now we start off in Traverse Town. This will be fun.
Where's that too?
Hey, you know, maybe we ought to go find Leon. Oh, Donald, you know, I bet you that,
What do you know, you big Pinocchio?
What do I know? Come on, Pluto!
The blue, yellow, and orange orb are money orbs. M-U-N-N-Y. It's currency. But now that we're here, I'll do each world on a separate video as we keep going. Now remember, these videos will tend to get a little bit longer considering the sheer amount of content. But once I save here, I will be ending the stream. And also keep in mind, eventually, any drops like money, health, or magic orbs will eventually disappear if you don't pick them up. So later on, it'll be a good idea to invest in draw abilities, which will draw items and orbs to you. So, for now, with all that out of the way, I'm going to be saving here and ending the video. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.